change is now rearing its head when the administration is exiting the system. What I mean by this is that, you know, in 2015 when we came in, we came on the basis of three particular promises that we made. Then I was in APC. We talked about the security, the economy, and then, of course, corruption. But so far, it was lack of adherence to our promises that made some of us to exit APC and joined the PDP. However, pressure that is being exerted to APC now, APC is making some kind of U-turn now. You can see that the performance of the budget last year and this year, you know, was not as it was before. Before, in the implementation of the budget, we used to have a 60% implementation level, 70% at best. But I can tell you from documents that I have sourced, in 2021, we are having more than 80% performance on prorata basis. So we are hoping that by the end of the year, the implementation level probably will be more than anything that we have seen in the first before. But I have my own reservations on this budget and how possible it is for us to be able to implement it. A budget of 16.39 trillion with a deficit of 6.26 trillion, and parameters that are very optimistic, is going to be very difficult for us to be able to achieve our targets in such a way that we'll be able to implement this budget the way we wish the implementation to come out to be. If you look at the deficit is about 38% of the entire budget. While if you look at the component of the budget that constitutes the capital segment of the budget is about 32%. So if you look at 38 and 32, relatively speaking, it means that part of the money that is going to be borrowed is going to finance the current expenditure, because only 32% is supposed to be required to service the proposed capital expenditure spending in the budget. However, not even that. If you look at the 68 or so to say percentage point for the recurrent, what is the purpose of recurrent? Recurrent has two components. First component is personnel cost. The second component is overhead cost. Why do we provide overhead cost in the budget? The purpose of making provision of overhead cost in the budget is to support the expenditure budget. That is to say, all the monies that are allocated for overhead costs are to be used in the implementation of those projects that have been captured in the capital budget. But when you have a small capital, you know, budget allocation, why should you have such a colossal amount invested in overhead cost or the current budget? I think, you see, the point is that we have to be, how do I put it? We must be, the word is,
discipline?
Eh?
Discipline?
No, it's not a question of discipline. You see, it's a question of whether or not we are prepared to face reality. The preparedness of us to face reality is that we must slim down our recurrent expenditure for us to be able to have enough funds to allocate to capital expenditure. Because look at it, if you look at this way, how many, what is the population of Nigeria? Nigeria, its population is getting to about 200 million. Now, out of the 200 million, how many of us are actually civil servants? How many of us are civil servants up to 2 million. Are they up to 2 million? The entire 67% of the budget is devoted to civil service expenditure.
That's
overhead. Yes, the whole of overhead and personnel cost is meant for civil servants, except for the ministers that are also part of the executive arm of government, which form the component that we are talking about. So unless when we want to hold the bull by the horn and be prepared to do what is best for Nigeria and Nigerians, then only we'll be able to come up with a budget that is proportionate to the level that is required to bring about the necessary development that everybody is looking for. If you look at even the way the budget was prepared, there is no equity. Some geopolitical zones were marginalized, like my own geopolitical zone, Northwest, where I come from. If you look at the rail development, is there any proposal for any rail line from Kontagora, Yawuri, Bininkebi, Sokoto, Ilela, Sabumbrini, and the Kaura Namoda? There is no such plan. They only talk of Lagos-Kano. Lagos-Kano, if you now take Lagos-Kano, from what point is Northwest affected? Northwest is from where? Is it from Jeri? Is it from Jeri? Because all this road, because all this Tapa and the rest are all North Central. Mm. So virtually these things, yeah, and even in 2016, we argued, some of us, I was in the Committee of Works, and what we are proposing, we say, well, if you are going to do this project, and you take it as a one-line project, okay, let's start from both ends. Mm. So that you start the project from Lagos, and at the same time, commence work from Kano. So that they will meet somewhere in the middle. But if by any chance that this project is terminated halfway, and it's only from Lagos, we'll be left in the cold. GOEs, as they are called, government-owned enterprises that generate most of the revenues that accrue for government expenditure. You see, a lot has been achieved. So much progress has been made. If you compare the revenue that was generated 2 years back and today, there is a significant increase in the revenue generation. And also, the Senate actually made it very difficult for MDAs to play the kind of games they were playing in the past. It has been since 1999, there has not been any Senate committee on public accounts that rendered any report on the floor of the Senate. The ninth Assembly Committee on Public Accounts actually went out of its way to ensure that it submitted a report. And the report now has made MDA's executives to now become G3. And I am telling you, and I'm sure, that because of that, all of them will be on their toes to ensure that the expected, in fact, some of them will be even going beyond the targets that have been set for them.